So now we will start solving some exercises. So if you have any doubt with anything that we took before, don't worry, we will solve everything from the very basics and we will practice everything. So at the end of these videos, you will master everything we took, okay? So this is the first exercise. Define a structure type for student containing the following members: name, ID, and grades for three courses. When you finish, we want to make a variable of type student and initialize its members, or basically just put some values inside the members. It's not necessary initialization. So let's start by making our structure. So we'll use type def and want to make a struct. Now this struct will be called student, right? Now in here we will put our members. So let's make the first member ID, so it will be an integer ID. The second member is name, so char name, this is a string, suppose it's maximum 10 characters. And now we want grades for three courses. As you can see, we were not told to make a structure for a course. We only need three grades. So this would be an array of doubles, for example. Let's call it grades, and it has three elements. Perfect, so this is our struct, and now let's make a variable of type student. So student, and let's call him S1. And let's initialize some of his members. So his ID, let's say it is 110, and his name is student1, for example. Now, as you can see, we are initializing the members in order. So this is the first member, and this is the second member. Now we want to initialize these three grades. So we have to do something like this. We will say grades sub 0, so this is the first grade, is equal to 10, for example. And we'll do the same thing with the other grades. So let me copy this. And over here, let's say the second grade is, for example, 9. And the third grade is 5, for example. And over here, we'll put sub 2. Now let's print these members. So printf, we want to print an integer, a string, and three doubles. So %lf, %lf, %lf. First of all, we want to print s1.id, then s1.name, then s1.grades sub 0, so like this, also s1.grades sub 1, and s1.grades sub 2, like this. Perfect. Let's try the program, build and run, and as you can see, everything is perfect. This is the ID, this is the name, and these are our three grades. Now, let's make a function that takes a student as a parameter and fills it. First of all, I'm going to make this function by value, so you see that we have to make it by reference. So void, let's call it fill student, like this, and it takes a student s. Inside here, we will say scanf, and we want to read five things: the ID, the name, the first grade, the second grade, and the third grade. Now, let's copy these over here and put them here, okay? So the ID will be stored over here, the name will be stored over here, the first grade, the second grade, and the third grade. Perfect. Put a semicolon, and this is our fill student function. Let's remove these values and initialize all the values to their default value, like this. Now, let's fill student, and we will give it our S1, okay? Build and run the program. Oops, over here we have S, not S1. So let's rename this over here to S1. Now, build a program, open the logs, zero errors, zero warnings. Build and run. So now we are entering the ID. So let's say 110, student 1, like this. Now the three grades. So 10, 20, 30. Press enter. And whenever we print these values, we can see 0, empty string, and 0. So these are our default values. So what happened? We made a new student called S1. And we set it equal to the student that we took as parameter. So S1 in this function is equal to S1 inside the main, okay? Because this is passed by value. Now, inside this function, we read the values of this S1. And whenever we exited this function, this S1 was destroyed. And the S1 inside the main was not affected. So we still see the default values. Now let's pass by reference. So we put a pointer, right? And over here, let's edit this code to work with pointers. So put an arrow over here also. So just like this. So now this S1 over here will point to S1 inside the main. and we are filling S1 inside the main over here. Perfect. Now, before building the program, we have to give the address over here, right? Now, build another program and let's enter some values. So let's say 110, student 1, 10, 20, 30, press enter. And as you can see, our student is updated perfectly. So as you can see, we are moving step by step, and don't worry, everything will be clear. This is it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.